You want me to read it?
Yes. Just no more reading. No, like tahajjud. Just no more. Let's say Rashid, today's not here.
Yes, sister.
Assalamu alaikum, my young audience, and welcome back to this week's kids program. Unfortunately, Rashid is busy with something else today, so it'll just be me by myself. So please, my dear young viewers, don't forget to call in and recite with us anything you want, whether it be Quran, Nasheed or Qasida, poems, stories, facts, it could be Islamic or non-Islamic, and many more, but make sure you please call in. So before we start today's topic, I'm going to start by reading three surahs. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Qul hu Allahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Wa lam yakun lahu kufuwan ahad. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. Malikin nas. Ilahin nas. من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد صدق الله العلي العظيم
اللهم
صل على محمد وآل محمد. So today we're going to talk about the marriage of Bibi Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam and Imam Ali alayhi salam, as today is the first of Dhul-Hajj and it was the day that they got married, which was the second year of Hijrah, and Mubarak to you all. So how did they end up getting married? Before Imam Ali, when Fatima grew up, two old companions asked her father for a hand in marriage, but he turned away from them in disgust and said, "This matter of the marriage of Fatima, my daughter, is in the hands of Allah himself, and he alone will select a spouse for her." Allah duly made his selection. He selected Imam Ali to be Fatima to Zahra's husband. He wished to see Fatima and Imam Ali married. So how did Imam Ali propose? 2 months after the Battle of Badr, Imam Ali alayhi salam called upon Prophet Muhammad and said, "O Messenger of God, you have brought me up as your own child. You have overwhelmed me with your gifts, your generosity, and your kindness. I owe you everything in my life. Now I seek one more kindness from you." Prophet Muhammad understood what Imam was trying to say. His face lightened up in a broad smile and told Imam Ali to wait so he could get Fatima's answer. Prophet Muhammad entered the house and told Fatima that Imam Ali was asking for her hand in marriage, and what was her response? She kept quiet. Prophet Muhammad interpreted her silence as her approval. He then returned to Imam Ali and informed him that his proposal was accepted and told him to make preparations for the wedding. So on the last day of Dhul-Qa'dah, Prophet Muhammad invited the Muhajirin and the Ansar to attend a banquet on the occasion of the marriage of his daughter. He was going to be their host. When all the guests arrived and were seated, once again obtained the formal consent of his daughter for her marriage with Imam Ali alayhi salam. Prophet Muhammad praised Allah and thanked him for his mercies. He then read the sermon of marriage, declared Ali and Fatima husband and wife, and invoked the blessing of Allah upon them. The guests congratulated Prophet Muhammad on this auspicious occasion. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. And after the ceremony, the guests feasted upon lamb meat, bread, date, fruit, and milk. So Imam Ali and Fatima to Zahra are living together. A few days later in Dhul-Hajj, Fatima to Zahra had to bid farewell to her home so she could go to the house of her husband. Her father assisted her in riding the camel, and Medina rang with the shouts of Allahu Akbar. A few days later, the Prophet Muhammad asked them both how they found it living with one another. They both found it great. Between Ali and Fatima to Zahra, there was total identity of interests. They were both brought up and educated by Prophet Muhammad and Lady Khadija alayhi salam. Therefore, they both shared the ideals of their parents. Both put service to God ahead of everything else. There was absolutely no room for disagreement, and their marriage was therefore just as perfect and just as happy as the marriage of Prophet Muhammad and Lady Khadija alayhi salam. Bibi Fatima alayhi salam used to do lots of housework, cooking, cleaning, etc., and was inflicted by great pain as a result of this. So Imam Ali alayhi salam asked her, "Why don't you ask your father for a servant to relieve you from these jobs?" Fatima alayhi salam went to visit her father, but found he had company and was too shy to speak to him. But the Prophet knew she came for something, so he visited her and Imam Ali the next morning. Fatima was shy once again, so Imam Ali told the Prophet that maybe they need a servant. The Prophet said, "Shall I teach you something that is better for you than a servant and a world with everything in it?" After every prayer, say Allahu Akbar 34 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, and Subhanallah 33 times. Did you know this? Then conclude that with La ilaha illallah. Surely this is better for you than that which you wanted and the world and its belongings. Thus Fatima did to this after every prayer, and it became to be known as Tasbihatul Zahra. Did you know this? So Fatimatul Zahra's children. As noted before, Fatima's greatest pleasure was to wait upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She spent most of her time in prayer, and Allah was pleased to bestow upon her four children. Imam Hassan alayhi salam was born in the third year of Hijra. Imam Hussein alayhi salam was born in the fourth year of Hijra. Zainab was born in the sixth year of Hijra, and Kulthum was born in the seventh year of Hijra. Ahlul Kisa. The Ahlul Kisa are made up of five people: Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Imam Ali alayhi salam, Imam Hassan alayhi salam, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and Bibi Fatima alayhi salam. One day, the Prophet, peace be upon him, visited Fatima alayhi salam at her house. The Prophet said he felt weak and told Fatima to fetch him a Yemeni cloak. He then told Fatima to wrap it over him, and then noticed his face, and she noticed his face was glowing like the moon. A moment later, Imam Hassan came up and said, "I'm smelling the fragrance of my loving grandfather," and then asked the Prophet, peace be upon him, if he could enter. The Prophet replied, "O my son, the owner of my fountain of Kothar, you may enter." Soon after, Imam Hussein came and said he could smell the fragrance of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and also asked to enter. The Prophet replied, "O my son, the interceder of my ummah, yes, you may enter." Then Imam Ali came and asked to get inside the cloak and was accepted. Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam then finally followed and entered under the cloak. The Prophet then said, "O Allah, these are my Ahlul Bayt. These are my confidants and my supporters. Bestow your peace, mercy, forgiveness, and pleasure on them and on me, and keep them away from uncleanliness, and keep them pure and thoroughly purified." The archangel Jibreel asked Allah, "O Lord, who are these inside the cloak?" The Lord said, "These are the Ahlul Bayt of the Prophet and their sets of him: Fatima to Zahra, her father, husband, and two sons." Jibreel asked Allah if he could join them, and Allah said yes. Jibreel was able to enter the cloak and said, "Allah sends his revelations to you and has decided he should keep you and your Ahlul Bayt clean of all pollution and purify you people, the fire purification." Then Imam Ali said to the Prophet, "Tell me, what merit is coming under this cloak has before Allah?" The Prophet replied, "When any of our Shias and supporters will assemble in gathering and narrate this hadith, Allah will bestow upon them his blessings and mercy. Angels will encircle them, and as long as they do not disperse, the angels will pray for their forgiveness of their sins." MashaAllah. Try to recite and learn this hadith al-Kisa, as it has many benefits for us. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. So now I'm going to move on to the sayings of the Prophet in honor of Lady Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam. So the first saying is about loving Lady Fatima. "Whoever loves my daughter will be with me in the heaven, and whoever holds grudges against her will reside in hell." May Allah make us love Lady Fatima and be with Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam in heaven. The second saying is the best in worshipping Allah. Fatima alayhi salam is the best companion in the path towards serving and worshipping Allah. The third saying is about her being the dearest. Fatima alayhi salam is the dearest of people to me. The joy And the fourth saying is the joy of her father's heart. Fatima is of my flesh, who is the light of my eyes and warmth of my heart. The fifth saying is about injustice to Lady Fatima alayhi salam. Woe to whoever does wrong to my daughter Fatima alayhi salam after my death. The sixth saying is about paying visit to Lady Fatima alayhi salam. Visiting Fatima alayhi salam equals to visiting me. The seventh saying is about part of her father. O Fatima alayhi salam, you're part of me and I'm part of you. The eighth saying is about his deep love for her. O Fatima alayhi salam, I'm ready to give my life for you. The ninth saying is about her being a heavenly angel. Fatima alayhi salam is an angel who smells like heaven. The tenth saying is, verily Allah has poured faith and belief into the veins of Fatima alayhi salam. Thus she is consistent in worshipping Allah. The 11th saying is about her marriage. I did not give permission for Fatima alayhi salam marriage until I received Allah's command as to her marriage. The 12th saying is about Lady Fatima alayhi salam's status. My daughter's light is of Allah and her status is higher than heaven and earth. The 13th saying is the four honored women. Heaven looks forward to four women: Mary, the daughter of Joachim, Asiya, Pharaoh's wife, Khadija, and Fatima Muhammad's daughter. And the last saying is about asking Allah's pardon for others. O Fatima, I give you the glad tidings of holding a high status in Allah's regard, which provides you with the power to ask pardon for others. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. So I think, do we have any callers before we, as we have only a few minutes left in this program? Do you have any callers? Okay, no, I don't see any callers. Yeah, I think we've actually finished here today. So mashallah, this was very interesting today. I hope you all learned something that you didn't know already. And thank you so much for being with us today. Jazakumullah. Thank you to all who have, make sure you to come back again next week and make sure we want more callers next week. Exactly. And inshallah, we'll see you next Thursday at 7:45 p.m. Please tune in, stay safe, and salam to you all.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سورة الفاتحة المباركة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم إني أسألك من رحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء وبقوتك التي كهرت بها كل شيء وخضع لها كل شيء وظل لها كل شيء وبجبروتك التي غلبت بها كل شيء وبعزتك التي لا يقوم لها شيء وبعظمتك التي ملأت كل شيء وبسلطانك الذي على كل شيء وبوجهك الباقي بعد فناء كل شيء وبأسمائك التي ملأت أركان كل شيء وبعلمك الذي أحاط بكل شيء وبنور وجهك الذي أضاء له كل شيء يا نور يا قدوس يا نور يا قدوس يا نور يا قدوس يا أول الأولين ويا آخر الآخرين اللهم اغفر لي الذنوب التي تحت كل عصام اللهم اغفر لي الذنوب التي تنزل النقام اللهم اغفر لي الذنوب التي تغير النعام اللهم اغفر لي الذنوب التي تحبس الدعاء اللهم اغفر لي الذنوب التي تقطع الرجاء اللهم اغفر لي الذنوب التي تنزل البلاء اللهم اغفر لي كل ذنب أذنبته وكل خطيئة أخطأتها اللهم إني أتقرب إليك بذكري وأستشفع بك إلى نفسي وأسألك بجودك أن تدنيني من كربك وأن تزيعني شكرك وأن تلهمني ذكرك اللهم إني أسألك سؤال خاضع متذلل خاشع أن تسامحني وترحمني وتجعلني بقسمك راضيا كانيا وفي جميع الأحوال متواضيا اللهم وأسألك سؤال من اشتدت فاقته وأنزل بك عند الشدائد حاجة وعظم فيما عندك رغبته اللهم أظم سلطانك وعلى مكانك وخفي مكروك وظهر أمرك وغلب كهروك وجرت قدرتك ولا يمكن الفرار من حكومتك اللهم لا أجد لذنوبي غافرا ولا لقبائحي ساترا ولا لشيء من عملي الكبيح بالحسن مبدلا غيرك لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك وبحمدك ظلمت نفسي ظلمت نفسي ظلمت نفسي ظلمت نفسي وتجرأت بجهلي وسكنت إلى قديم ذكرك لي ومنك علي اللهم مولاي كم من قبيح سترت وكم من فادح من البلاء أقلت وكم من إثار وكيت وكم من مقروح دفعت وكم من ثناء جميل لست أحلى له نشرت اللهم أذم بلائي وأفرط بي سوء حالي وقصرت بي أعمالي وقعدت بي أغلالي وحبسني عن نفعي بعد أملي وخدعتني الدنيا بغرورها ونفسي بجنايتها ومطالي يا سيدي فأسألك بعزتك ألا يحجب عنك دعائي سوء عملي وفعالي ولا تفضحني بخفي ما اطلعت علي من سري ولا تعاجلني بالعقوبة على ما عملته في خلواتي من سوء فعلي وإساءتي ودوام تفريطي وجهالتي وكثرة شهواتي وغفلتي وكن اللهم بعزتك لي في كل الأحوال رؤوفا وعلي في جميع الأمور عطوفا إلهي وربي من لي غيرك أسأله كشف ضري والنظر في أمري إلهي ومولاي أجريت علي حكما اتبعت فيه هوى نفسي ولم أحترس فيه من تزيين عدوي فغرني بما أهوى وأسعده على ذلك القضاء فتجاوزت بما جرى علي من ذلك بعد حدودك وخالفت بعد أوامرك فلك الحمد علي في جميع ذلك ولا حجة لي فيما جرى علي فيه قضاءك وألزمني حكمك وبلاؤك وقد أتيتك يا إلهي بعد تقصيري وإسرافي على نفسي معتذرا نادما منكسرا مستقيلا مستغفرا منيبا مكرا مذعنا معترفا لا أجد مفرا مما كان مني ولا مفزعا أتوجه إليه في أمري غير قبولك عذري وإدخالك إياي في سعة رحمتك اللهم فاقبل عذري وارحم شدة ضري وفكني من شد وثاكي يا رب ارحم ضعف بدني يا رب ارحم ضعف بدني يا رب ارحم ضعف بدني ورقة جلدي ودقة عظمي يا من بدأ خلقي وذكري وتربيتي وبري وتغذيتي أبني لابتداء كرمي وسالف برك بي يا إلهي وسيدي وربي أتراك معذبي بنارك بعد توحيدي وبعد من طوى عليه قلبي من معرفتك ولحج به لساني من ذكرك واعتقده ضميري من حبك وبعد صدق اعترافي ودعائي خاضعا لربوبيتك هيهات أنت أكرم من أن تضيئ من ربيت أو تعبد من أدنيت أو تشرد من آويت أو تسلم إلى البلاء من كفيته ورحمت وليت شعري يا سيدي وإلهي ومولاي أتسلط النار على وجوه حرت لعظمتك ساجدا وعلى ألسن نطقت بتوحيدك صادقا وبشكرك مادحا وعلى قلوب اعترفت بإلهيتك محققا وعلى ضمائر حوت من العلم بك حتى صارت خاشعة وعلى جوارح سعت إلى أوطان تعبتك طائعا وأشارت باستغفارك مذعنا ما هكذا الظن بك ولا أخبرنا بفضلك عنك يا كريم يا ربي وأنت تعلم ضعفي عن قليل من بلاء الدنيا وعقوباتها وما يجري فيها من المقارح على أهلها ألا أن ذلك بلاء ومكروه قليل مكفوه يسير بكاؤه قصير مدته فكيف احتمالي لبلاء الآخرة وجليل عقوء المقارح فيها وهو بلاء تطول مدته ويدوم مقامه ولا يخفف عنها أهله لأنه لا يكون إلا عن غضبك وانتقامك وسخطك وهذا ما لا تقوم له السماوات والأرض يا سيدي فكيف لي وأنا عبدك الضعيف الذليل الحقير المسكين المستقيم يا إلهي وربي وسيدي ومولاي لأي الأمور إليك أشكو ولما منها عضج وأبكي لعليم العذاب وشدتي أم لطول البلاء ومدتي فلئن صيرتني للعقوبات مع أعدائك وجمعت بيني وبين أهل بلائك وفرقت بيني وبين أحبائك وأوليائك فهبني يا إلهي وسيدي ومولاي وربي صبرت على عذابك فكيف أصبر على فراقك وهبني صبرت على حر نارك فكيف أصبر عن النظر إلى كرامتك أم كيف أسكن في النار ورجائي أفوق فبعزتك يا سيدي ومولاي أقسم صادقا لئن تركتني ناطقا لأضيجن إليك بين أهلها ضجيج الآملين ولأصرخن إليك صراخ المستصرخين ولأبكين عليك بكاء الفاقدين ولأنادينك أين كنت يا ولي المؤمنين يا غاية آمال العارفين يا غياث المستغيثين يا حبيب قلوب الصادقين ويا إله العالمين أفتراك سبحانك يا إلهي وبحمدي تسمع فيها صوت عبد مسلم سجن فيها بمخالفتي وضاق طعم عذابها بمعصيتي وخبس بين أطباقها بجرمه وجريرتي وهو يضج إليك ضجيج معمل لرحمتك ويناديك بلسان أهل توحيدك ويتوسل إليك بربوبيتك يا مولا فكيف يبقى في العذاب وهو يرجو ما سلف من حلمك أم كيف تؤلمه النار وهو يعمل فضلك ورحمتك أم كيف يحركه لهيبها وأنت تسمع صوتا أم وترى مكانا أم كيف يشتمل عليه زفيرها وأنت تعلم ضعفا أم كيف يتقلقل بين أطباقها وأنت تعلم صدقا أم كيف تزجره زبانيتها وهو يناديك يا ربا أم كيف يرجو فضلك في عتقه منها فتطرقه فيها هيهات ما ذلك الظن بيك ولا المعروف من فضلك ولا مشبه لما عاملت به الموحدين من برك وإحسانك فباليقين أقطو لولا ما حكمت به من تعذيب جاحديك وقضيت به من إخلادي معانديك لجعلت النار كلها بردا وسلاما وما كان لأحد فيها مقرا ولا مقاما لكنك تقدست أسماؤك أقسمت أن تملأها من الكافرين من الجنة والناس أجمعين وأن تخلد فيها المعاندين وأن تجل ثناؤك قلت مبتدئا وتطولت بالإنعام متقرما أفمن كان مؤمنا كمن كان فاسكا لا يستوون إلهي وسيدي فأسألك بالقدرة التي قدرتها وبالقضية التي حتمتها وحكمتها وغلبت من عليه أجريتها أن تهب لي في هذه الليلة وفي هذه الساعة كل جرم أجرمت وكل ذنب أذنبت وكل قبيح أسررت وكل جهل أملت كتمته أو أعلنت أخفيته أو أظهرت وكل سيئة أمرت بإثباتها الكرام الكاتبين الذين وكلتهم بحفظ ما يكون مني وجعلتهم شهودا علي مع جوارحي وكنت أنت الرقيب علي من ورائهم والشاهد لما خفي عنهم وبرحمتك أخفيت وبفضلك سترت وأن توفر حظي من كل خير أنزلت أو إحسان فضلت أو بر نشرت أو رزق بسطت أو ذنب تغفر أو خطأ تستر يا ربي يا ربي يا رب يا ربي يا ربي يا رب يا ربي يا ربي يا رب يا إلهي وسيدي ومولاي ومالك ركي يا من بيده ناصيتي يا عليما بضري ومسكنتي يا خبيرا بفقري وفاقتي يا ربي يا ربي يا رب يا ربي يا ربي يا رب أسألك بحقك وقدسك وعظم صفاتك وأسمائك أن تجعل أوقاتي من الليل والنهار بذكرك مأمورا وبختمتك موصولا وأعمالي عندك مقبولة حتى تكون أعمالي وأورادي كلها وردا واحدا وحالي في خدمتك سرمدا يا سيدي يا من عليه معولي يا من إليه شكوت أحوالي يا ربي يا ربي يا رب يا ربي يا ربي يا رب يا ربي يا ربي يا رب قوي على خدمتك جوارحي واشدد على العزيمة جوانحي وحبلي الجدة في خشيتك والدوام في الاتصال بخدمتك حتى أصرخ إليك في ميادين السابقين وأسرع إليك في البارزين واشتاق إلى قربك في المشتاقين وأدنو منك دنو المخلصين وأخافك مخافة الموقنين وأجتمع في جوارك مع المؤمنين اللهم ومن أرادني بسوء فأريد ومن كادني فقيد واجعلني من أحسن عبيدك نصيبا عندك وأقربهم منزلة منك وأخصهم زلفة لديك فإنه لا ينال ذلك إلا بفضلك وجد لي بجودك وعطف علي بمجدك واحفظني برحمتك واجعل لساني بذكرك لهجا وقلبي بحبك متيما ومن علي بحسن إجابتك وأقلني أثرتي واغفر زلتي فإنك قضيت على عبادك بعبادتك وأمرتهم بدعائك وضمنت لهم العجابة فإليك يا رب نصبت وجهي وإليك يا رب مددت يدي فبعزتك استجب لي دعائي وبلغني مناي ولا تقطع من فضلك رجائي واكفني شر الجن والإنس من أعدائي يا سريع الرضا يا سريع الرضا يا سريع الرضا اغفر لمن لا يملك إلا الدعاء فإنك فعال لما تشاء يا من اسمه دواء وذكره شفاء وطاعته غنى ارحم من رأس ماله الرجاء وسلاهه البكاء يا سابخ النعام يا دافع النكام يا نور المستوحشين في الظلام يا عالما لا يعلم صل على محمد وآل محمد وافعل بما أنت أهل وصلى الله على رسوله والأئمة الميامين من آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا صلوات اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سورة المباركة الفاتحة اللهم صل على محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم إني أسألك الأمان يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم وأسألك الأمان يوم يحض الظالم على يدي يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا وأسألك الأمان يوم يرفع المجرمون بسيماهم فيؤخذ بالنواشي والأقدام وأسألك الأمان يوم لا يجزي والد عن ولدي ولا مولود هو جاز عن والده شيئا إن وعد الله حق وأسألك الأمان يوم لا ينفع الظالمين معذرتهم ولهم اللعنة ولهم سوء الدار وأسألك الأمان يوم لا تملك نفس لنفس شيئا والأمر يومئذ لله وأسألك الأمان يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغني وأسألك الأمان يوم يود المجرم لو يفتدي من عذاب يومئذ ببني يومئذ ببني وصاحبته وأخيه وفصيلته التي تؤويه ومن في الأرض جميعا ثم ينجي كلا إنها لظى نزاعة للشوى مولاي يا مولاي أنت المولى وعن العبد وهل يرحم العبد إلا المولى مولاي يا مولاي أنت المالك وعن المملوك وهل يرحم المملوك إلا المالك مولاي يا مولاي أنت العزيز وعن الدليل وهل يرحم الدليل إلا العزيز مولاي يا مولاي أنت الخالق وعن المخلوق وهل يرحم المخلوق إلا الخالق مولاي يا مولاي أنت العظيم وعن الحقير وهل يرحم الحقير إلا العظيم مولاي يا مولاي أنت القوي وعن الضعيف وهل يرحم الضعيف إلا القوي مولاي يا مولاي أنت الغني وعن الفقير وهل يرحم الفقير إلا الغني مولاي يا مولاي أنت المعطي وعن السائل وهل يرحم السائل إلا المعطي مولاي يا مولاي أنت الحي وعن الميت وهل يرحم الميت إلا الحي مولاي يا مولاي أنت الباقي وعن الفاني وهل يرحم الفاني إلا الباقي مولاي يا مولاي أنت الدائم وعن الزائل وهل يرحم الزائل إلا الدائم مولاي يا مولاي أنت الرازق وعن المرزوق وهل يرحم المرزوق إلا الرازق مولاي يا مولاي أنت الجواد وعن البخيل وهل يرحم البخيل إلا الجواد مولاي يا مولاي أنت المعافي وعن المبتلى وهل يرحم المبتلى إلا المعافي مولاي يا مولاي أنت الكبير وعن الصغير وهل يرحم الصغير إلا الكبير مولاي يا مولاي أنت الهادي وعن الضال وهل يرحم الضال إلا الهادي مولاي يا مولاي أنت الرحمن وعن المرحوم وهل يرحم المرحوم إلا الرحمن مولاي يا مولاي أنت السلطان وعن الممتحن وهل يرحم الممتحن إلا السلطان مولاي يا مولاي أنت الدليل وعن المتحير وهل يرحم المتحير إلا الدليل مولاي يا مولاي أنت الغفور وعن المذنب وهل يرحم المذنب إلا الغفور مولاي يا مولاي أنت الغالب وعن المغلوب وهل يرحم المغلوب إلا الغالب مولاي يا مولاي أنت الرب وعن المربوب وهل يرحم المربوب إلا الرب مولاي يا مولاي أنت المتكبر وعن الخاشع وهل يرحم الخاشع إلا المتكبر مولاي يا مولاي irhamni bi rahmatik warḍa 'anni bi judik wa karamika wa fadlik ya dhal judi wal ihsan wat tawli wal imtinan bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin salawat allahumma salli ala muhammadin wa ala.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيب نفوسنا وشفيع ذنوبنا أبي القاسم محمد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا محمد وآل محمد. Respected brothers and sisters, my dear young audience, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask him sincerely to bless all of us and to give us, inshallah, better health. Those who are not well, ya Allah, cure them. Bi barakati Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. And those who are in difficulties, ya Allah, we ask you to remove their difficulties. Bi barakati Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Ya Allah, and our marhumin, all our brothers and sisters, our fathers and our mothers and grandfathers and grandmothers, and all mu'minina and mu'minat and muslimina and muslimat, ya Allah, we ask you to make them enter into your mercy. Bi barakati surati al-mubarakati al-fatiha with salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim Maliki Yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوات اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد. Respected brothers and sisters, we start our program today by reciting few verses from Surah Al-Fajr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this noble surah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسر هل في ذلك قسم لذي حجر ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بعاد إرم ذات العماد التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد وثمود الذين جابوا الصخر بالواد وفرعون ذي الأوتاد الذين طغوا في البلاد فأكثروا فيها الفساد فاصطب عليهم ربك سوط عذاب إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَا ابْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَّمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمَنِ وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. In these verses of Surah Al-Fajr, we see that Allah the Almighty says, after Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent, he says, Wal Fajr, I swear by the dawn, I swear by Fajr, Walayalin Ashr, and I swear by the 10 nights, Washafi Wal Watr, and the even and the old, Washafi, and the even days, Wal Watr, and the odd days, Walayli Idha Yasr, and the night when it passes on. Hal fi dhalika qasamun lidhi hijr, is there sufficient assurance as oath in that for mindful persons? Then Allah says, Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi'ad, have you not considered what your Lord did with the people of Ad? Irama, that il imad, of Iram, men of tall pillar buildings. Allati lam yukhlaq mithluha fil bilad, the like of which were never created in the countries. Wa Thamud, and how did he deal with people of Thamud? الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ, who had cut rocks and carved houses in the valley, which is known as Qura Valley. وَفِرْعَوْنَ, and with Pharaoh. Have you not considered what Allah did with Pharaoh? ذِلْ أَوْتَاد, the owner of forces. الَّذِينَ طَغَوْا فِي الْبِلَادِ, who were all rebels and tyrants in the land. فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ, so they had exceeded in corruption. فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطُ عَذَابٍ, hence your Lord wiped on them the disaster of punishment. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ, indeed your Lord is ever watchful. مِرْصَادِ, Labil Mirsad, is always ever watching. Fa'ammal insan, thus as for human being, idha mabtalahu rabbu, when his Lord tries him, fa'akramahu, by giving him honor, wa na'amahu, and by giving him favors, fayaqulu rabbi akraman, he says, my Lord has honored me. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ, and when he tries him, فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ, and tries him and restricts his provision, his rizq, فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا, then he says, my Lord has humiliated me. And then Allah says in ayah number 17, كَلَّا بَلَّا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ, no, rather you do not treat the orphans with honor and kindness. وَلَا تَحَاضُّونَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ, and you do not encourage each other to feed the poor. These verses are in Surah Al-Fajr. Our discussion tonight is not about tafsir of Surah Al-Fajr, but our discussion tonight is about the holy month which we are in, and this is the month of Dhul Hajj. Dhul Hajj is one of the months which are known as sacred ones. Ashhurul Hurum. This is a holy month. It is in this month we know that Dhul Hajj is known as the month of Dhul Hajj because there is in it the biggest gathering in the world in terms of worshiping Allah alone, and that is Hajj. But unfortunately, this year, Hajj will not be the same like other years. Those who went for Hajj last year and the years before, they know how busy it was and how beautiful it was when you go to do your ibadah of Hajj. Whether you are doing Tawaf, or you go between Safa and Marwa, or you go to Arafat, or you go to Mina and Muzdalifah, it was tiring ibadah, but at the same time, it was so enjoyable. Every time you finish that ibadah, you want to do again. Now imagine this year, Hajj will not be the same again. Only few people will be there for Hajj, but we all, you and me, we need to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers and sisters, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove whatever tests and tribulations Allah has brought them to us, to remove them so that inshallah the ibadah of Hajj can be performed again in a better way than it was before. It is a wake-up call to those who are mas'uleen of Hajj, those who used to take care of people when they go for Hajj, and even for the Hujjaj who used to go time and again. It was something for many people that, oh, Hajj is here, we'll go and we'll do our ibadah, we'll come back. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested each and every one of us to say, remember, there is Lord. He is the one who decides whatever will happen with his house, Baytullah al-Haram. This house belongs to Allah, the Almighty. It not belongs to anybody. No, it belongs to Allah. The masjid belongs to Allah, Masjidul Haram. And the house Al-Kaaba, Baytullah al-Haram. And the month which we are in, Shahrullah al-Haram. We need to remind one another about the merits of this month, which is Shahrullah al-Haram. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, it has been narrated that he has said, ma min ayyamil amali fiha ahabbu ila Allahi azza wa jalla min ayyami hadhihi al-ashr. There are no ibadahs which can be done in terms of ibadah in other days which will be more dearer in the eyes of Allah min ayyami hadhihi al-ashr, like the days which are 10 days of this month of Shahru Dhul-Hajj. And par the surah which we have just recited, Surah Al-Fajr, Allah the Almighty clearly says, Wal-Fajri wa-layalin ashr. I swear by the Fajr, the dawn, and the 10 nights. These layalil ashri, according to Mufassirin, they say these are the nights of Shahru Dhul-Hajj. This month, dear brothers and sisters, there are a lot of merits in it during the days as well as the night. We remember that in this month, the ninth of this month is known as Day of Arafah, a day which, subhanAllah, a lot of merits are connected with the Day of Arafah. For those people who have been for Hajj, you know, Day of Arafah is a day of repentance. Everyone wearing ihram, they go to the plains of Arafah. And there's nothing more you can do in Arafah than dua. You are there just to wait. From just before Dhuhr, of course, people go a night before or from Fajr, and they stay there until Maghrib. What do you do there in Arafah? In the plains of Arafah, it's just to wait, to do istighfar, pray, relax, and do whatever you can do. But it is a day which has got a lot of lessons to remind us that sometimes in this world, we don't need to rush to do our things. You need just to wait and just wait. Do ibadah, do istighfar, do whatever you can do, but just wait. And in Arafah, people wait there. So now, subhanAllah, we are in this time, this season, there is this disease, coronavirus. Now, what can we do? We remember that there was a time in the early days when there was a lockdown. Lockdown is just wait, stay in your house, don't go out, don't go shopping, nothing, just wait. It's a good thing to wait. Allah has opened many doors for us to think. When we wait, we are not rushing. You think, you plan, you execute your plan, you start a life afresh. It's a good, we do need break. We need sometimes to take break. When we don't want to take, we ourselves, a break, Allah may bring something, then we can find all of us, we are taking break. So we shouldn't blame Allah, but we should thank Allah. And that's why it's good to say, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for any state and any condition which comes to us. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Day of Arafah is a day which will remind us about the day when we are going to be resurrected from our graves. Everyone will be wearing a white clothing, nothing more. And that is your kafan. It reminds you about that. Day of Arafah is so special. Now we are not in Hajj. We are going to stay here. The day of Arafah is important for us to remember that, you know what? What you can do on the day of Arafah, if you are not there, this is the day of dua. Do a lot of supplications. And inshallah ta'ala, we will try to make an arrangement where we will inshallah broadcast the program live on the day of Arafah, where we can share the treasure of Ahlul Bayt with you in terms of dua, and there are many types of dua on the day of Arafah. The 10th day of Dhul Hajj is the day of Eidul Hajj. 10th of Dhul Hajj is the day of Hajj, the day of Eid, where we are going inshallah ta'ala to pray Salatul Eid together and celebrate the merits of this day together inshallah. 18th of Dhul Hajj is the day of Ghadir, Eidul Ghadir, when we are going to remember Mawla al-Muwahideen, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Asadillahi al-Ghalib, Imam al-Mashariq, Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. And this is the day when we are going to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala itmami ni'ma wa ikmali deen. Ikmali deen, to complete the religion, wa itmami ni'ma, and to fulfill the blessings upon us by appointing Amirul Mu'mineen as Amirul Mu'mineen. Ali bin Abi Talib as Amirul Mu'mineen. Wasiyu Rasulillah bila fasl. It is an important day, day of celebration, day of remembering the merits of Amirul Mu'mineen Ali bin Abi Talib. But all these days, when now we remember the first day of Dhul Hajj, it was the day of the wedding, call it marriage, between Amirul Mu'mineen Ali bin Abi Talib and Fatima to Zahra, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. But before we go there, I would like to take this opportunity, my dear brothers and sisters, to remember, to remind each and every one of us to remember that there are a lot of acts of worship we need to do in this month. Number one is fasting. Fasting in the month of Dhul Hajj, these 9 days, day one up to day nine, day of Arafah, fasting in these days, there are a lot of blessings, there are a lot of barakah, there are a lot of rewards for those who are able to observe fasting. And scholars have mentioned that the merits of fasting in these 9 days will equal like fasting the whole umr, the whole life in this world, subhanAllah. So if you are able to observe fasting, you cannot observe all the 9 days for fasting, at least observe few days in this month. Don't let the month to go without fasting. It is highly recommended. And of course, we need to do a lot of istighfar. My dear brothers and sisters, asking for forgiveness is very important. Since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned many merits of istighfar, for example, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to punish us, if we do istighfar, he may stop that punishment to come to us. And he says clearly that in the Holy Quran, for example, in Surah Al-Anfal, ayah number 33, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah will not send punishment on them while you are among them. You, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are among them. Allah will not punish them so long as you are with them. And in the same ayah, Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. And Allah is not he who punished them while they are seeking forgiveness. Istighfar is very important for us. Whatever is happening now within this world, we don't know. Maybe we are the reason, maybe others from our same brothers and sisters within our communities or other communities, we don't know. The only thing we know, we possess istighfar. If we do istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish us, insha'Allah ta'ala. There are many istighfar we can recite in this month. Let us try to do as much as we can. Another thing which is very important for us is to give sadaqah, charity. It's very important to give charity. Charity in this month, charity in normal days, will bring a lot of blessings to us when we give sadaqah to those who are in need. And subhanallah, there is this sadaqah, this charity, which is known as qurbani. It's very important to do it. Qurbani, there are many people who sometimes they don't get opportunity to eat meat. Yeah, other places around the world, people are able to do a lot of things. They can eat whatever they want. But there are places where people are in need. Qurbani, send, whether it is money or it is that qurbani, as in terms of animal, to feed those who are in need. And ya Allah, there are many places, my dear brothers and sisters, people suffer. We hear now a lot about Yemen, for example, that more than 20 million people suffer. They are facing starvation. 12 million of those are children. Help them in whichever way you can do that. If you can help those in Yemen, help them. You can help those, for example, in Africa, help them. Those in India subcontinent, help them. Wherever, and including the places where you are, there are many people who suffer. Help them, feed them, clothe them, and of course, pray for them. It's very important. The benefits will come back to you. And there are many types of adhkar we can do, including Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. This Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, there are many types of this dhikr. You can find them in Mafatihul Jinan or in the websites where du'as have been mentioned. Try to do these chanting adhkar will help you to make you go closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, to pray salah between Maghrib and Isha, two rakats. You recite in the first ayah, in the first rakah, Suratul Fatiha, and Qul Huwallahu Ahad, and in the second, Suratul Fatiha, and that one ayah, which you can find in the books of dua, including Mafatihul Jinan. Try as much as possible to keep this salah mustahabba, which will make you to come to get the benefit of it, inshallah. And of course, above all, send salutations to the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, in order for you to get more blessings regarding salawat. And of course, the fiqh issues are always there. If you have salah or you have fasting, which is fasting to be paid as qada, you need to do that, because qada comes first. Once you have completed your qada, then of course you can do your mustahabbat. And talking about the first day of Dhul Hajj, the day of marriage between Imam Amirul Mumineen Ali bin Abi Talib salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi and Lady Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam, as we understand, that was the happiest occasion in the life of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, when he saw his cousin and his daughter are getting married. And the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he himself recited the khutbah and he pronounced the marriage of Amirul Mu'mineen, Ali al-Murtada, in Fatima to Zahra alayhim as-salam. When they got married, the whole Medina was happy, and the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam participated in terms of preparation until the end of the marriage. This was a beautiful day in Medina. So now when we remember that the Holy Prophet encouraged Amirul Mu'mineen to get married, and then he didn't block him to say that I need a big dowry, I need this, I need that. He wanted to make everything easy. There are a lot of lessons we can learn from the wedding of Amirul Mu'mineen and Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam. Number one, parents, if you have your daughters, you have your sons, make it easy for them to get married. And try as much as possible to plan, to arrange, to do whichever way is possible to make sure marriages are happening. And of course, our daughters too, our children, make sure you don't make it difficult for you to get married. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, ma buniya fil Islam bina'un ahabba ila Allahi wa a'azza. Ahabba ila Allahi azza wa jalla wa a'azza min at-tazwij. There is no any building which has been built in Islam which is more dearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and more holier than at-tazwij. In Islam, you cannot become a pious person by avoiding getting married. You cannot. Taqwa doesn't come when you say, I'm not going to get married. Rasulullah, is there someone who is better than Rasulullah? No, of course, Rasulullah is afdalul khalqi. He is Sayyidul Rusuli, Sayyidul Anbiya'i wal Mursaleen. The Holy Prophet, he was the most noble of all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he married and he had more than one wife. He didn't say that this will stop me in ibadah. No. Man tazawwaja faqad ahraza nisfa dini falyattaqi Allaha fi nisfi al-akhar. Anyone who gets married, he will be safeguarding one half of his religion. And the second half, he should pay attention to other kinds of ibadah. Getting married is very important. And that's why Sayyidatu Nisa'il Alameen, Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam, as we understand, the Holy Prophet clearly said, Lawla Ali, if it were not for Ali, Fatima wouldn't have any husband to marry. Because few came to propose and the Holy Prophet rejected. And he said, I'm waiting for the command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when that was materialized, he pronounced the nikah of Amirul Mu'mineen, the Aqd of Amirul Mu'mineen, and Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam, they got married. So when we look at the life of Amirul Mu'mineen and Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam, we see that this marriage was the exemplary marriage. There were no problems within it until actually some scholars say when they use the verses of the Holy Quran to express and explain how it was so nice, they say, La tasma'u fiha laghiya. You will not hear any problem within that marriage. There were no shouting, there were no fighting, there was nothing except respecting, mutual understanding and respecting. And that's another lesson for those who are married. Brothers and sisters, life is so difficult. Sometimes the husband comes home tired and he thinks about the problems which were outside there. When he comes inside the house, he brings all the baggages with him inside the house. And then he forgets to say good salam, even to say nice words to the wife, nor even any sort of showing that he is in good relationship with the wife and the children. Sometimes problems happen because this sister, maybe she was waiting for the husband to come, and then the husband comes, you can see him in a difficult situation. He doesn't know even how to express that. Problems may happen. Let us always remember the marriage of Ali bin Abi Talib and Fatima to Zahra alayhim as-salam. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was there always to help them. And here we are learning that we as members of our communities, we should always try to strengthen the marriages of our brothers and sisters, not to put petrol in the fire when there are problems in order for marriages to break down. That is haram. We shouldn't do that. And let us always remember that we have obligation to try as much as possible to make sure our communities get married, because that is a good thing by itself to be done. I can see the time is not with us, but we need to remember to try as much as possible to do a lot of ibadah in this month, and to try as much as possible to help those who are in need, and to try as much as possible to elevate ourselves spiritually. Spiritually, not just by praying and fasting, but also to help those who are in need. And eventually, when we have problems within our marriages, let us try to look at the marriage of Amirul Mu'mineen Ali bin Abi Talib and Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam. We need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through them to bless our marriages, to bless our children, to bless insha'Allah ta'ala our houses through the names of Ali and Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam, and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala those who are not married, ya Allah, make them marry. And those who are in marriage but they don't have children, ya Allah, bestow upon them obedient children. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our dua, forgive our sins, and allow us to be better people in this month, Shahrullahi al-Haram, Dhul Hajj. And inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill the hajat of all muhtajin, to cure all the marid, and to have mercy on all our marhumin, bi barakati Muhammad. Wa Ali Muhammad, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. And finally, we recite Suratul Mubarakatul Fatiha for all our marhumin. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladhina an'amta alayhim.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Aliyan Waliyullah. Ashhadu anna Aliyan Hujjatullah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala falah. Hayya ala al-falah. Hayya ala khairil amal. Hayya ala khairil amal. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Allahumma ij'al qalbi baran wa amali saran wa aishi karan wa rizqi daran wa auladi abraran wa ja'alli inda qabri nabiyyika Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam mustaqarram wa qararam bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma